out here. It's Monday, the 27th of February, 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. Very busy for me over the last couple of days, actually. Last time I think I spoke to you was Thursday, wasn't it? So Friday we had the karaoke, which went very well. After that, I drove up to my sister's house in Lincolnshire. Oh, yes, we do nighttime driving. It's so much easier. No traffic or anything like that. You just get in your car and you wish up there. Although I've got to tell you, I don't go too mad on the roads. Certainly not in the last couple of years. I've slowed down a lot. And the maximum I do is about 75. That's true, that is, on the A1M and all that business. So, yes, it was the A1M I went up on. On halfway there, so this would be about 1:30 in the morning, I got a phone call from my nephew, Jimmy. He's 19. And he's like, "Are you coming? Are you on your way?" And I'm like, "Yes, I'm on my way now." And he's, "Are you coming anywhere near Lincoln?" And no, I don't go that far up. You see, the road goes up, carries on to Lincoln, but I come off before that. And I'm like, "No, why?" "Oh, it doesn't matter then." Now, I'm sure he knows I don't go as far as Lincoln. Thank you, Gustav. Done it. I'm sure he knows I don't go as far as Lincoln. But I said, "Oh, what? Where are you?" And he said, "Well, we're just in a nightclub at the moment." I said, "Well, send me your postcode and I'll put it into my sat-nav and I'll tell you how long I've got to go." So I've had to pull over now, of course, you know, to work the sat-nav. So I pulled over and he's given me the postcode. Da-da-da-da. I said, "Right, OK, I'll be there at 3:10. Are you sure?" "Well, of course I'm sure. Otherwise, I wouldn't have said it, would I?" So that's it. So I put the phone down. Anyway, I continued my journey. I actually got there about 3:00, came round Lincoln, and it was quite easy to find. Well, I thought it was easy to find. I've pulled up this road. I've gone right from one end to the other. You know, generally towns have a road where all the nightclubs are, aren't they? Unless you're in London, in which case they're all over the place. But certainly towns, like, they kind of have a road and that's where all the clubs are. And I only found one club and there's no sign outside this place. I've got, it must be a bit further. Of course, I've got to the end of the road now and it's one way. So I've had to come all the way round again and back and started it. And I've pulled up outside this club. Along with the Prius minicab drivers. Oh, yes, they've got them up there in Lincolnshire as well. Prius minicab drivers. And I got out of the car and there was this young lad coming towards. "Excuse me, can you tell me where?" Now, I think it was called Mocha. I think the club was called Mocha. "Can you tell me where Mocha is, please?" He said, "Oh, yeah, it's just there, mate." Right next to it, of course. "Oh, right, OK." So I closed the door, got out of the car, closed the door, locked up. Beep, beep, locked the door. Walked around to see if I could see my nephew. I couldn't see him anywhere. So then I'd done something really stupid. I mean, how stupid can you be? So this club, the doors are open, hundreds of people pouring out. It looked like a big place to me. And I then went to the door staff. "Excuse me, have you seen Jimmy anywhere?" I mean, how stupid can you be? Of course they don't know who Jimmy is. It's like, you know, when you get someone that, "Oh, I'm from Australia," and you know someone in Australia. "Oh, do you know Brad who lives in Australia?" No. It's a bit like that, isn't it? I actually thought the security staff, of course they wouldn't know my nephew. You know, he's like a little saint in there. Doesn't do anything wrong, I'm sure. And at that point, I thought I'd give him a ring and I rung him up. And I said, "Well, where are you?" And then I could hear him in the other ear. So I looked round and he's walking down because they've just got a pizza, him and his friend George. Just been up to the pizza place. So they got in the car and George, his friend, has got verbal diarrhea. The pair of them are drunk and he's talk and talk and talk and talk. Earlier in the evening, they'd been to see the Rat Pack. Now, that is obviously not the original Rat Pack, the like a Rat Pack tribute band. Now, who is that again? That's Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, and I can't remember the other one. Someone post up there if you could remember the other one, the other member of the Rat Pack there. So I got in the car and they're chatting away. Well, George is chatting on and on and on. And he kept going on about this girl that he'd seen dancing on the stage with feathers and all that and how beautiful she was and all this. On and on. Oh, he was drunk, dear. Very drunk. Got home, got back to my sister's house. She got up. And by now it's about 4:00 in the morning. So we had tea and toast. George continued to talk and talk and talk. And we had tea and toast. And then I think I went to bed about half past four in the morning. Now, usually I can't sleep very well at my sister's. So this time I downloaded this app on my iPhone that plays different sounds. And I had the rain, I think it was heavy thunderstorm with rain on window. I think that's the one I was playing. If you type in sleep help or sleep sounds into your app shop or something like that, you'll come up with a whole range of this, all free, no charge, all free, and you can just play them if you have trouble sleeping at night, or in particular, good help for people with tinnitus. If you've got that in your ears all night long and all day long, that would help you sleep with that because you're concentrating on the sound. But a little word of advice with those sleep apps, don't have them on too loud, because what you find is that as the night goes on, if you're still having trouble sleeping, they get louder and louder and louder. So just have them on very quietly, you know, so you're kind of straining to hear because I think your ear does something and it's like the automatic turner. Do you remember on the cassette decks where you had that automatic volume increaser thing? So if something was quiet, it would turn up the volume. Unfortunately, in those days, the volume would turn up and it also introduced more hiss into it. There's no hiss here. Listen. Can you hear any hiss? No, nothing here in the studio of United Kingdom Talk. No hiss at all. So I got off to sleep. In the morning, I got up and I was just getting dressed and I went to the toilet and Jimmy was already up with George and went downstairs for a bit of breakfast. What did we have here? Can't remember now what we had for breakfast. Oh, my sister did us a lovely cook's breakfast. Oh, I had a fried egg, baked beans and those triangular potato hash browns. Delicious. I don't do anything like for that, Maya. Oh, it was so lovely. So nice. So we had that, at which point Jimmy come, how did you do that dent in your door? And I thought, oh, here he goes again. You know, winding me up again. I said, there's no dent in the door, Jimmy. He said, yes, there is. Yes, there is. I said, Jimmy, there's no dent in the door. You're not going to get me with that one. He said, come on, have a look then. I said, I'm not getting out and having a look. It's cold. Not having a look. He said, please, on my life, there's a dent in your door. Well, I said, well, I'm not getting out of the door. He said, well, look through the blinds. And I went like that with the blinds. And I thought, where's the dent? Where's the dent? Look there. Look just to the left. There's a dent in my door. And only a little one. And you have to look to see it. But nevertheless, a dent in my door. Oh, no. And I've been so careful with it. So I haven't done that. And it's on the door that you would park towards the road. So clearly, someone, probably an Uber taxi driver, has watched this show and hates me. So has dented my door. Oh, no. Fortunately, that is the very job that my nephew does. He does dents and spraying and rubbing down and all that business. He can make, let me tell you now, my nephew can make your very old car look brand new. So I said, well, just give me a date and I'll come up. He said, well, why don't you just take it to Toyota? That's nearer to me. I want to give you the job. I want to give you the money. I want to give you the money. Don't do me any favours. No family rates or anything like that. I want to give you the money. There's another job for you. Okay, he said. I said, well, right, what time are you starting? He said, what do you mean? I said, well, it's half 11 now. You might be able to get that done before the wedding vow renewal do that we were going to. I'll tell you about that in a minute. And he said, well, I haven't rung him yet. I said, well, what about now? He said, well, I've got to get the dent man. I said, what do you mean the dent man? He said, well, I have to get someone else in. He knocks the dent out and then he makes it look like brand new. And he's got, I think Jimmy's got three jobs. He's got a little unit up near where he lives in Woodall Spa. And after noticing the dent, he took me around the unit because I haven't been there yet. Wow. And he's got all these jobs on the go at the same time. He's completely respraying an old Capri. Do you remember those? Ford Capri with the great long noses. I had one of those once, which I didn't really like it, to be honest. Great big blooming long nose. I mean, for what? Was it this long nose was pointless. So he's respraying one of those at the moment, and it looks brand new. It absolutely looks brand new, this Capri. He's got a motorbike, that middle bit in the motorbike, you know, where you put the petrol tank, that bit. He's doing that and a couple of bumpers in there. And he's saying, yeah, that one's £2,500. That one's 450. That's 250. I've got another job coming in Monday. So what he does, once he's done a job, then that has to dry before they can do anything else to it. So he gets another one in. He blooming well, he's 19 and he's got his own business. I'm just over the moon with that. so impressed. So we looked at that, and that was very good. And then after that, we went back to my sister's house. By now, it's about 2 o'clock. It's about 2:30, and I'm feeling a little bit sleepy now because of the long drive up there. Also, my allergy has kicked off. Now, I must say, I wasn't sneezing too badly, but I could feel my whole face was puffed out. This is, if you're new to the show, you won't know this. Whenever I go to my sister's house, she's got two dogs, and I am hypoallergenic in that house. It's terrible. Sneezing, coughing, you know, the old asthma things go, you know, every 10 minutes I've got the blooming asthma thing. Oh, it's awful. And you're like, oh, like that. You're like that all the time. Oh, it's just dreadful. So I popped upstairs. I think I managed about half hour sleep. And then we had to get up to go to the event. Now, the event that I went up for was a renewal of wedding vows between my nephew, Gary, not the 19-year-old. Gary's 32, I think, and his wife, Stacey. And, of course, they've got the three children as well. Little Olivia, there's Evie and Harry. OK, so this was a wedding vow renewal. Now, I've never been to one of these. And I've not actually found anyone else that has been to one either. So it was all, you know, quite interesting what was going to happen. So we went to the church. We got there. The thing was due at 4:00. We got there at like 30 seconds to four. I'm never late like that. Anyway, it had got cold outside, so we couldn't wait to get into the church in the warm. Ha! That was wrong. Wasn't warm in the church. My God, it was cold in there. Lovely old church, St. Peter's in Woodall Spa. That's a Church of England church. So not a real church, really. Do you know what I mean? It's not Catholic church. So it's not really not a real church, I'm afraid. Oh, dear. So it's cold in the church. And then I heard my sister say, she was sitting in front. She said, oh, here she comes, here she comes. So I look around and Stacey's walking up. And I thought, well, where's the music? You know, I'd already looked on the board. There were all these hymns. And I thought, that's a lot of hymns for today. But there was no music. So she's kind of walking up and like having a conversation with the priest. Not the priest, with the vicar as she's walking up. She got to the front and they sat down and did a little bit of a welcome and all that. But it turns out there was no music at all. I was a bit disappointed at that. You know, we do like to have a good sing-song in church, dear. And a little bit of wedding music or something like that. There was no music at all. Isn't that odd? But that must be what they wanted. So, you know, whatever they want is good by me. I just thought I would like to have a little bit of a sing-song, a bit of organ. There was absolutely no music whatsoever. No organ, no tape, no CD, nothing. So I thought that was a bit odd. Anyway, so the service started. And very quickly, I was brought up to do the reading. Now, the reading wasn't a religious thing. It was like a passage from a book, if you see what I mean. So someone had written this and I was just to read it out. So I read that out. I tried to introduce a little bit of humour into it. You know, we do like to do humours. If you want me to do your funeral reading, I'm happy to do that, but I will have people laughing. We're not having any of that crying business. But this wasn't a crying occasion. This was a nice occasion. So I tried to make it a little bit humorous. So we did that. And then I went back down again. And actually, it just didn't seem very religious to me. But I suppose that's how it was supposed to be. It was all over and done within about 20 minutes. After which, you know, we left the church. There was no collection or anything like that. And then we went to a pub. I think it was called the Abbey Lodge. Again, in Woodall Spa. And, you know, every time I went past that car now, I could see the dent. I kept saying, Jimmy stayed with me all the time, so car-wise. So I said, Jimmy, go on the other side. I can't look at that dent. Every time I went round that car, I could see that dent. Now, the funny thing, I never spotted it in the first place. If he hadn't pointed it out, I'd probably still be sitting here now, not even talking about it, because I hadn't seen it. Oh, dear. So we went in there. That was a lovely pub that they'd chosen to have that. We all sat down. There's a few tables and all that laid out. I meant to tell you, in my sister's house, that was on the Saturday morning. So in my sister's house, in the morning when I got up, my niece's two children were there. That's George and Emily. And I do like to muck about with the kids, as you well know. I usually get into terrible trouble with my sister. Why are you doing that? Why are you teaching them that? Because it's fun. Because I am a child still. You know that. I am still a child. And there was one bit where we were mucking about and everyone's having cuddles. And I said, oh, there's no one to cuddle. Emily, who's three, is sitting on my sister, her nan, knee. Right? And I said, oh, there's no one to cuddle me. Nobody loves me. And I put my eyes down like that. And little Emily said, I love you. And got off my sister's knee and came over and put her arms around me. How lovely is that? That was my highlight of the whole weekend. That moment. So nice. So nice. This is the sort of moment that you have where you think to yourself, you know, you want a camera running 24 hours a day to catch those times, don't you? Huh? So nice. That was the second moment is just coming up. You'll love this. So we're in the pub. We're sitting there, you know, chatting away. We're all feeling a bit peckish now, you know, because no one's had anything to eat before since breakfast. And every now and again, I saw, you know, Cadill, where's the sandwiches? Where's the sandwiches? Is there any sandwiches? Nothing there. No sandwiches. And eventually my sister came over and she said, oh, they're booked for 6 o'clock. Well, it's 4:15. We're all starving. She said, we'll have a bag of crisps. I said, no, I'm off crisps. I've given up crisps for Lent. At which point she said, well, it's not Lent yet. I said, I know, I started early. And that's worked, but I've lost a pound in weight. I've lost a pound in weight. Thank you very much. So I'm off the crisps. But then I was so tempted by the devil himself. The devil himself, i.e. George, came up. This is little George, not big George who was drunk. Little George, who had a bag of crisps and gave me two. Not two bags, two crisps. Now, I think I can get away with two crisps as it's not Lent. If it was Lent now, I would be struck down with bolts of lightning and thunderclaps like that. No crisps during Lent. So I just had two little crisps. And then we chatted away. Lady sitting next to me, Bernie. She's lovely, Bernie. And other children were talking to me as well, from various children, from various parents and that. And to fill in the time, there were these balloons. It was a mobile DJ set up. Now, he was quite good. But when he used the mic, I couldn't hear him. He wouldn't like, you know, you've got to belt it out when you're using a mic. There's no point, oh, hello, everything. And, he talked okay. He just couldn't hear what he was saying. You know, if you've got a crowd in front of you, you've got to belt it out. That you can't do it by halves because no one's going to take any notice of you. So he was playing the music. Nice selection of music he was playing. Lots of flashing lights and things. And there were balloons everywhere on this, like, little dance floor. And all the children were playing with the balloons. Well, I felt left out. So I felt compelled, boys and girls, compelled to go down and join the children. So there I was, banging the balloons around. I said, right, OK, Harry, come on, horsey time. So I then dropped onto four knees. This is in the jacket and the trousers and the nice shoes. I'm on all fours now. OK, I am being horse. So Harry, he's my nephew's boy. He's got on my back, followed by Evie, who got on my back. There is now another child attached to one leg, another child attached to the other leg, and two children attached to my arm, and I'm pulling the whole lot forward. And the people in there who know what I'm like, they were having a good time. The other people were looking at me as if I was some sort of mad person. But there you go. No, you go and sit in the chair and have your boring adult conversations about money and where you work and who's died recently. Not interested. Thank you. I'm on the floor with the children. That is where I am happiest. Although it did wear me out a bit. I seriously was pulling along about seven children, all attached to various limbs of mine. Oh, dear. Anyway, that was finished. So when I got up there, I started to tackle me with balloons. Eventually, I managed to get out of the situation and went down and sat next to my sister. I said, well, how much longer for the lunch? She said, another 10 minutes. I thought, oh, my God. And then suddenly, here's the second highlight of my... Of the whole weekend, there was suddenly a crash. of plates. And I looked over to where the plates were stacked. They were on the floor, table turned on its side, and Harry sitting next to them all. Harry somehow had managed to pull the table open complete with plates. He just got up and walked off. I can't believe there were only four plates broken. Well done, Harry. That's what we'd like to see. Oh, my Lord. Well, eventually the food came out. And, you know, it was quite nice. They did various wraps. Now, I thought the wraps had meat in, so I didn't have any. But later on, it turns out that one of them was vegetarian. But never mind. So they had wraps. They had cheese sandwiches, so I had a couple of those. I think ham and tomato sandwiches. They had curly chips. Bowls and bowls of curly chips. Very nice. I never understand why it is at these events, weddings and things like that. Why don't people bring out chips? Everyone likes chips. They're easy to do and my God, they're cheap. Aren't they? So they had chips and they had, onion rings. Yes, please. So I had a few of those. Piled my plate up, had those. So the party continued. And about 8 o'clock, I was really tired now. I mean, really tired. So at about 8 o'clock, I left and drove all the way home. And I got back here at about 11:30 on Sunday. I actually got back on... No, Saturday night, actually, Saturday night. So I was up there for less than 24 hours. But I got back here Saturday night, about 11:30. I think I had some... I stopped on the way home to get some vegetables. I got a vegetable soup. So I had some vegetable soup when I got in. And then I went to bed. And then Sunday morning, because I went to bed early, I managed to get up at 7:30 for church. Went to church, come back in here. But Sunday, I was absolutely shattered. I was kind of come up here and do a nighttime show, but I was so tired. So Sunday, went to church. And I think I went to bed about 3 o'clock. I watched some television. Got up again at about 5:30 on Sunday night. And then I thought, oh, I'll do a little show later. But I was so tired. I just didn't want to do it. So I ended up watching the telly and I watched 3 episodes of Roots, which for some reason is on BBC Four. Now, I don't understand that. Why is it on BBC? Because it's BBC One material. It's really good. It's horrific. It's absolutely horrific about what happened to the black people in America and England as well, where they're like, they were hundreds of years ago sold as slaves and all chained up and treated very badly. It's just horrendous. But you know, you need to watch this sort of stuff to be up on history. I mean, I have always known it went on and that, but I didn't really look too hard into it. When you see something like that on the telly and top marks to the television people for showing it, you know, it really goes to show you what those poor people went through, you know, being treated like slaves and all that. I quite like the two of the African names. Kunta Kinte. Kunta Kinte's in it. And Chicken George. Chicken George. Now, I think his name was George. But he liked getting involved in the chicken... Not chicken fights. Are they rooster fights? Rooster fights. Chicken... Cockfights. Cockfights. He liked getting involved in the cockfights because his master had all these birds. But his master is his father. Chicken George. His master is actually his father because he raped his mother. So he was called Chicken George because he had a lot to do with the chickens. But it's great. The whole thing is available on the iPlayer. It's a long old programme. I tell you, they're 90 minutes each. So I managed to watch 3 of those yesterday night. And then I went out for a little walk. I thought I'll go out for a walk because I haven't done any exercise today. Well, about 20 minutes into my hour walk, it started raining. Oh, my. And it poured down. No umbrella. No umbrella. There I was walking away. No umbrella. Poor old Chris got soaking wet. So I cut short my walk and it was 20 minutes up there. So it's still about 40 minutes walk. Came back in, done something to eat. I had some lovely strawberry Angel Delight. Then I watched a bit more television, episode 2 of SSGB, which again is excellent on the BBC. A couple of people have mentioned to me that they found the sound was pretty poor on that. I got to be honest, I found it okay. It's not too bad at all. Mind you, after people telling me that, I have had the sound on full blast anyway. And when I say full blast, I mean full blast. So that's probably why I didn't have any trouble hearing them. But it is ridiculous how these programmes keep coming out. You can't hear what the actors are saying. Apparently, last night's programme was better, which I haven't seen last night yet. I'm about halfway through that one. And now people are complaining it's too loud. Moan and moan. Why do they keep moaning? And then this morning, I went to bed last night again at about 11:30. I had a good sleep. This morning I got up. I had already recorded a show this morning. But it was all a bit rushed because I had to go out for a scan. Do you remember I went out to have a scan today down there on my... just down here, this bit here. This bit here, I've had a scan. Down there and all around this area here, I've had a scan. And I left the house and it hadn't uploaded. And while I'm in the car, my mate came round to pick me up and take me down to the place they were doing the scan. It wasn't a hospital, it was just an outpatients thing that we have in Bracknell here. While we're on our way there, and I thought, oh, I'm not happy with that show today. So you haven't seen it, and it get deleted before because I didn't think it was particularly good. So that's why I'm doing another one now. You see a live one now. So I had my scan. We walked into the scan place, you know, usual miserable old cow on reception. So we walk in and we're standing there, right? We're sat right in front of it. Can I help you? What's all that about, eh? Why can't people just be pleasant to you? What is all that about? I said, yes, I've just got this. Oh, OK, Mr. Redden, yes, sit down over there. It will be called. And we were 20 minutes late for the appointment. As I'm sitting there, two elderly people have come out of the room. And immediately this lady came in. And Christopher Reardon, yes, please. Oh, would you like to come through? Oh, great. You know, got sore early. So the scan, it's not like the long scan. This is like the ultra scan, you know, just like a little wand that they wave over you like that. A little bit like Star Trek, but without Captain Kirk and his tight black trousers. So I'm laying on the bed. Ronnie's with us as well. So he's watching it all on the screen. I'm just laying there. And there's no pain or anything like that. Actually, the gel wasn't even cold. That, you know, sometimes they put that gel on and it's cold, but it wasn't. And I had to breathe in like that and hold my breath while they're doing it. Because if you don't do that, it's all fuzzy. Once you breathed in, everything becomes clear. And Ronnie was telling me, actually, afterwards, you can see everything. You can see your kidneys, the shape of them. You can basically see the shape of them all there while she's going up and down like that. The lady was ever so nice doing the scan. And that all went well. Nothing to report. Nothing there that looks unusual or misshapen or anything like that. If you're a regular viewer, you'll know I've got a bit of a problem, like a pressure problem here. When I'm laying in bed, sometimes it's on my back, sometimes it's always on this side. And she thinks it could possibly be wind that isn't getting out. And I could go along with that because I don't really much anymore. I don't do that much. I don't know why. It doesn't seem to be getting out. So I think I've got to go back to the doctor now and see what if there's anything to do next. But nothing at all abnormal to report or anything like that. So I'm quite pleased about that. We then went to Waitrose for a couple of tea and toast because I couldn't eat anything for 6 hours. So I've had nothing in the morning. Oh, I'm terrible without tea in the morning. I have to have a cup of tea in the morning. Not today, dear. No, not before they were doing that. Nothing to eat or drink for 6 hours. Then I came back here. We went to Waitrose, as I say, done a little bit of shopping, come back here. And here I am, chatting away to you. That was my last few days. OK, let's say hello to some people this morning who are joining us. Millions of people all over the world. Good morning to Adam, Joey, Gustav. Thank you. Wendy's with us. Good afternoon to Stephen Racinus, I think you're in Australia, aren't you, sir? Hello to you, sir. No, why am I saying happy birthday? We haven't done any birthdays yet. Claire Norton is with us this morning. Alan Russell, good afternoon. Timothy Thomas says, did you see the fake news about the cure for AIDS and the backlash from it from Facebook? Yes, I did. I did. And I actually unfriended someone for that. what they do, you see, this is what people do is they see a news story and quickly cut and paste without reading the whole news story or finding anything about it. You know, and people with serious conditions, AIDS, not necessarily AIDS, HIV, AIDS, cancer, heart troubles, whatever it is, they see something like that. Oh, wow. And it's just not fair. So I actually unfriended someone for that one, Timothy. Yes, I did see it. Ridiculous. There is no cure yet. There is no cure. Alan says, reception is quite bad here. What? What do you mean reception? Is this, we're not FM, are we? There must be something wrong with your wires going in your house, Alan. The lovely weather. Oh, it's horrible today. Hello to Elaine. Says, how about those Oscars, Chris? Oh, a waste of time. I don't watch any of those... any of those award shows, ever. I never watch them. And they're all spouting off political stuff as well, aren't they, Elaine? What's all that about? Just go up and get your cup. We don't need the speech about how much you hate Donald Trump or Hillary Clinton or Jeremy Corbyn or anyone like that. We don't need that. Just go up, collect your cup, say thank you and piss off. What the hell is all that about? They all went up there and they just, going, oh,
what's all that about?
Just go up and get your cup. We don't need...
That's me, isn't it?
Sorry. They just keep going up there and spouting off political statements. Well, we don't like them for that. We like Katy Perry because she sings. You know, whether she don't like Theresa May or Jeremy Corbyn or whoever, we're not interested in that. Are we? Are we? Surely not. Not interested in how you vote. I don't know who Bruce Forsyth votes for. I don't understand why they go up there and do the whole political thing. It's unnecessary. Unnecessary. Anne says, I get lots of that with fibromyalgia, people sending links. Yeah, it's not funny, is it? I mean, I suppose sometimes people see these things and, you know, they think you're doing you a favour. But if I sent someone like something like that, you know, here is a cure for cancer. If I sent someone a link like that, I would say, look, I found this on the internet. Not sure if it's true. Have a read. But we keep having these stories all the time. Adam says he blocked that person as well. Oh, you saw the same one as me then, Adam, did you? Yeah. I think it was some sort of drag queen, was it? Thought it was funny to put something like that. Not funny. Not funny. Absolutely not funny. William is with us in Sydney. Hello, William. Is it Mardi Gras in Sydney? Do you know, I've never been to that. I'm too old to go to a Mardi Gras now, William. I really am. I can't see myself wandering around there in a pair of Speedos and a small white vest, can you? Hello to Tweety Charlotte saying, bitter people can't be pleasant. It's a shame they're in customer services. Well, they are, Tweety. That's just the whole thing about it. It's usually these customer services people must just employ the most miserable people in the world, except for certain ones, I have to say. If you've ever rung up Virgin, customer services there seems to be pretty good. John Lewis, pretty good as well. Waitrose, fantastic. But certain receptionist jobs... You know, their only little bit of power in the world is to say, no, you can't have an appointment today. That's their entire bit of power in the world. What is all that about? Thank you, Tweety. Tweety says, we have the TV shows that are on low volume. Then the commercial comes on at full blast. I can't stand commercials. Yeah, we have that as well. Not really as bad as it is in America, because I've seen American television and Australian, actually. In Australia as well, the commercials do seem to come up quite loudly, don't they? Yeah, so I'll go along with that as well. Let's have a look. Elaine is in and out because she's working hard. So if you talk to me and I don't comment, oh, don't worry about that. It's okay. It's okay. Gustav says, although... Oh, hang on, Gustav. Let's have a look. Gustav says, I did end up doing vodka shots with Maureen. Really? And I can confirm I did yet again give Chris's bottom a hefty firm squeeze, which he did on Friday. Gustav gave my bottom a squeeze on Friday. I was so excited and then I turned around and it was him. Oh, well. And he didn't object. The only way to describe it is welcoming. A very pleasant bottom. Anne says her dog loves crisps. He opens his own packets. We'll put them up on the fridge. A cat could get them, Anne. Tim says, with your allergy to dogs, you can have poodles or Hungarian poolies. Dreadlock dogs. Kerry and I have three pullies. I like dreadlocks on blokes, do you? Not white blokes. Looks stupid. Don't you think that looks stupid? Dreadlocks on white blokes. Got to be black. You can't have dreads. I mean, you can't, can you? Dreadlocks on white blokes. What do they look like, dear? No. Black men only, please. And we do like dreadlocks on black men. We do. Let's just scroll down a little bit there. Phone lines are not open yet. Not yet. Do you want me to open the phone lines? There you go. Phone lines are now open if you want to call in. 020-8144-3477. Why do you have a microphone here? Ah, now I did put it further away. You can see the microphone now. I did have it further away, but I was listening to it. It sounds a bit echoey when it... Look, if I move this further away, right? I mean, you've probably still got the volume there, but it sounds a little bit echoey, don't you think? So that's why it's back here. It was always here before, Elaine. It's only recently because Ray Reynolds was moaning. And, of course, the closer you get to it, the better it sounds, but I don't think you want it right up to my mouth like that, so it's kind of a bit of a play-off there. Oh, we've got a phone call coming in. London number... Hello, who's calling in from London?
Hello, Chris Reardon.
Hello, who's that?
It's your good friend Matt Joplin here.
Oh, Matt Joplin, DJ Matt Joplin, how are you?
I'm okay, I thought I'd make a rare appearance on United Kingdom Talk.
It is very rare as well. Now, Matt used to DJ in bars and clubs, but you've gone out and bought your own stuff now, haven't you?
Yeah, it's all in place now, Chris. I've got first gig coming up. 18th of March.
Right.
That's in Bromley. That's quite near me.
Yeah.
And
Where's that? So what's that for?
Looking for more.
So what's it for?
Yeah, just trying to get my name out there at the
Pay
moment.
Pay attention! Pay attention! What's it for, dear?
What's that?
What's the gig?
The gig is actually a 40th coming up in Bromley, so that'll be quite easy. I'd imagine that would be lots of 80s.
80s and 90s, yes.
A bit of 90s. And a bit of up-to-date stuff to keep the kids happy, probably.
Yeah, okay. Have you got lights?
Yeah, I've got lights. I've got some very nice lights and got a new laptop, and my friend's going to put all his music on there tomorrow.
Right.
Because he actually DJs at the minute, so...
You've bought a load of music, have you? Okay, yes.
Yes. Got CD players. Yeah, I just got the whole lot, really. It all cost me about $3,000.
Oh, wow. Did you have $3,000 or have you taken out a loan?
Well, no, it was a little bit of help from Daddy.
Okay, okay.
But, I had a little bit of savings. He helped me along the way, so that was very nice of him.
You better get some cards printed out with your phone number on
them. Cards, yeah, advertising and stuff. I don't know if Gumtree is any good. I've been looking at advertising on there, but I'm not quite sure about that.
Don't know. What lights have you got, or don't you know, really?
No, I can't really describe them.
Well, as long as they flash and turn around a bit, that'll do,
yeah,
I'm sure.
Yeah, I mean, I'll send you a picture later to your phone, whatever. You can have a look at them.
Oh,
yeah,
that's
it's
excellent.
It's all very nice. It's all very top quality stuff. So hopefully, sooner rather than later, I'll be getting out of retail work, because you know I don't like that, Chris.
Yeah, yeah. You work in one of the big shops at the moment, don't you? Don't say where it is, because someone might be watching it. Oh, you've got so-and-so working there, and he doesn't like his job, and then you'll be out, dear.
No, that's it. We can't advertise.
No, no.
Only my DJing services, of course.
Yes.
To your millions and millions of viewers.
Go on, advertise them, then. Let's hear you do an advert. Do you need a jingle? I might be able to find a jingle for you.
Yeah, anyone looking for DJ for parties, weddings, whatever? Should I give me a number?
Yes, go on if you want to. Is it a mobile number in it? Is that the number you're using for your job?
Yeah.
Well, dish it out, dear. Dish it out.
Yeah, anyone looking for DJs for parties, weddings, small pubs, bars, give me a shout on 0208-657-1707. That's the or the mobile 077-809-47228. Thank you very much, Chris. That's very kind of you.
That's all right. Anytime. I hope you get loads more work then.
Yes, thank you. I hear you've given up some nights now, have you?
Oh, yes, Tuesday and Sunday I don't work at the moment. There'll be another one.
You're enjoying your quiet evenings in, are you?
Yeah, there'll be another one going next year as well. I already know which one it's going to be.
Are you slowly retiring, dear?
Yes.
Well, you've done it for so long, haven't you?
I know. I don't take any DJ work now anymore. I mean, what you're doing, I don't do that.
In a year or so. I've never done it before, but I might think about getting into karaoke as well, because obviously that's where
karaoke
the midweek jobs are.
Karaoke would be a little bit harder for you, because it will end up costing you thousands of pounds in songs because you've never done it.
Yeah.
If you've been doing it for a while, you slowly build up these songs. Although I used to use Sing to the World, you know, with that thing, you don't need to have your songs. Or there's one called Lucky Voice or Lucky Star, I think. Lucky Star karaoke. Sing to the World is no good anymore because there's a lot of the songs that they've had to take off.
Yeah.
Due to a copyright
thing.
I think it's Lucky Voice or Lucky Star. They still have those songs on there. So look, let me look it up for you. You look at it. You will, of course, need an internet connection. Lucky Voice it is. LuckyVoice.com.
Lucky Voice, is it?
Yeah, you can sign up for that. I think it costs you about £5 a month or something like that. Mm-hmm. And probably get away with it like that for a while you're trying it out.
Yeah. Okay, thanks, Chris.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Nice to call in, dear.
Yeah, enjoy the rest of the show. See you later, mate.
Thank you, Matt. Bye-bye now. Bye. There we are. If you want a mobile disco, that's the one to do. Let me just save in it. Just a minute. I-N. And saved. Lovely. Yeah, as I say, I don't do any of those mobile discos anymore, weddings, birthdays. I'm kind of, fed up carrying around speakers. I've got some lovely little jobs I do at the moment. Lovely little jobs. And I enjoy each and every one of them. Right, back to some of your messages. Ian says, is that your new Toyota you dented? Yes, indeed, I'm afraid. Yes, but I haven't dented it. It's one of those things that just appeared. Someone's obviously slightly driven into it and misjudged, but there you go. One of those things. Alan says, I would have thought you put up the parrot picture by now. It is, but not in here. It's in the other studio. Now, I have ordered a new backdrop for here. It's light blue. It's a very light blue. I nearly went with clouds. I nearly went with little clouds, but we've gone for a plain light blue background there, which should come within the next couple of weeks. And then behind me, I will be changing some stuff around. The clock's probably going right over here. That and stuff there will be moved. But I would like, I've got a lovely black and white picture of London, which is at the moment in the living room. And I want to try and get that there. But I've got a feeling, even if I move everything slightly over that way, it might still be too big. I suppose the hearts, I think, are going to go. That might give us a little bit more space. And you see where the light is shining on there? That's just annoying, that is. If I move that... Oh, it's going to come down. It's nearly come down. The trouble is, with hanging stuff up with glass, you can get reflection. But it's not happened over there. That's quite... that doesn't reflect for some reason. So that's why I'll end up... What was I saying? Oh, the picture. Yeah, I would like going up over there. Thank you, Wendy and Gustav and Alan. Sammy Davis is the other member of the Rat Pack, isn't it? So it's Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin and Sammy Davis. Well, I might do that one today. Sammy Davis. Candyman. The Candyman can... I like doing that one at karaoke, yes. Karaoke tonight is at Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross in London. Okay, so Sammy Davis was the other one. Sorry, my darlings, these messages are not keeping up with you here. Where are we going there? No, that's wrong. Do that one there. That one there. Thank you very much, those of you that shared the programme, today's programme on your walls. That's always much appreciated, okay? Anne says, is it the shade of Barry's eyes? Has he got blue eyes? Oh, he has. Yes, I think it probably is, Anne. It's that light blue colour. Have I got anything that colour here? Don't know if I've got anything like light blue here. Oh, yes. There you go. That colour. It's a very, very light blue. Because we want to kind of keep it nice and bright in here. I did have black once, and that was just... it looked like an evil place where torture happens. We'd have had a couple of slings up here and people being tortured while I'm doing my... Would you like that, perhaps? Do you fancy the idea of that? Live torturings here on United Kingdom Talk? Is that appealing to anyone at all? Dear me. Have you bought any more, Chris? Have I bought any more what? Oh, Stacey enjoyed the speech on Saturday. I'm glad you did, Stacey. That's who did their wedding renewal vows on Saturday. That's Stacey there, wife of my nephew, Gary. I was a little bit worried it might be a bit too much, but it was, when you sent it to me, I wanted to just humorise the very serious message that was in there. Do you know... Do you want me to read out the piece from Saturday night? I'll read it to you. Let me read you this reading, okay? From Saturday. There it is. There it is. I've got it. Right. If I can just explain to you a little bit of background here. So my nephew and his wife, they have three children. There's Evie. She's the oldest. She's four. She likes donuts. There's Harry. He's three. He's very boisterous and not really afraid of anything. And he likes to take risks. He likes to take risks, especially when I'm playing TikTok with him, which is when I hold one hand and one leg on the same side of the body and I swing. And I swing higher and higher and higher so he can actually touch the ceiling, much to the worry of my sister. Oh, he's too high, he might hurt himself. Oh, for God's sake, woman. And then there's Olivia. Olivia is severely disabled. She can not really see. I think we think she can see bright lights. She can't walk and she will always have to have 24-hour care. She's now coming up to, I think, a year and a half, a year and three quarters, some age like that. OK, so at the wedding vow renewal, they decided to have this reading, which has a serious message in it. But I humorised it a bit and I'll read it. I'll read it as I read it at the church, OK? So the reading is, welcome to Holland. When you're going to have a baby, it's like planning a fabulous vacation trip to Italy. You buy a bunch of guidebooks and make your wonderful plans. The Colosseum, the Michelangelo David, the gondoliers in Venice. You may learn some handy phrases in Italian. Ciao bella! All very exciting. After months of eager anticipation, the day finally arrives. You pack your bags and off you go. Several hours later, the plane lands. The stewardess comes in and says, welcome to Holland. Holland, you say? What do you mean Holland? I signed up for Italy. Ciao bella! I'm supposed to be in Italy. Ciao bella. All my life, I've dreamed of going to Italy. Ciao bella. But there's been a change in the flight plan. They've landed in Holland and there you must stay. The important thing is that they haven't taken you to a horrible, disgusting, filthy place full of pestilence, famine and disease. It's just a different place. So you must go out and buy new guidebooks. And you must learn a whole new language. And you will meet a whole new group of people that you would never have met. It's just a different place. It's slower paced than Italy. Less flashy than Italy. But after you've been there for a while, you can catch your breath. You look around and you begin to notice that Holland has windmills. Can you do windmills? Do windmills. Do windmills. And Holland has tulips. And Holland even has Rembrandts. But everyone you know is busy coming and going from Italy. And for the rest of your life, you will say, yes, that's where I was supposed to go. That's what I had planned. But if you spend your life mourning the fact that you didn't get to Italy, you may never be free to enjoy the very special, very lovely things about Holland. That was bang on time then, wasn't it? And that was the reading. Isn't that beautiful? And you can hear the serious meaning there. And I just thought it was so nice when I read it the first time. I must say, I read it the first time. And I thought, oh, I don't know about this. You know, it's not really a church reading, if you see what I mean. There was no religion there at all. But when you've read it, when you listen to that like that, you didn't really need it, did it? So that was our little day there. 2012, Adam says, was when we had the black background. Was it that long ago? Gosh, I can't believe it. Thank you very much. All right, let's do some messages, actually, from Thursday's show, because I haven't been here since Thursday. Thank you very much for your messages, as always, that you send through. Simon says, on the subject of changing clothes, and I said the other day, you know, I don't always change my clothes every day. I mean, if they are smelling, I will do. But some of you have probably noticed, if you turn up to my karaoke nights or quiz nights, sometimes I've got the same shirt on as I've had on for the show. But remember, I'm only sitting here for an hour. It's unlikely to start smelling, stenching after an hour, is it? Surely. Simon says, if I have three separate gigs, Friday, Saturday and Sunday, in areas miles apart, what do? Is get a big, thick, smart jumper. What I do is wear it Friday night and then Saturday. Oh, we've got another call coming in there. Just a second. 0191. Where's that from? I don't know where that's from. Hello, who's calling in, please?
Mr. Reardon.
Who's that?
Hello.
Bonjour. Comment ça va?
Bonjour. Do you know who this is?
No idea. Gustav.
It's Mike from Newcastle.
Oh, hello, Mike. Have you lost your accent? Where's your accent gone? Are you trying to posh yourself up in preparation for a BBC radio job or something?
I'm trying to refine it, Chris. I'm trying to refine it for radio, but it's not working very well.
No, you should be able to get a job at you should be able to get a job at a BBC. They like accents now. They don't like normal speaking people. Hey?
Oh, dear me. What has happened to radio these days, Chris?
Oh, I don't know. It's all falling apart, isn't it?
Terrible.
Fortunately, Tony Blackburn's on all over the place again now, so I'm quite happy with that.
I don't like Tony Blackburn at
all. Yeah, and I know you like him. You know that Christo bloke who left LBC?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I kind of had high hopes for the one who took over, but he's even worse. He is so boring. Matt Stadler, is it?
Yes, that's him, yeah.
Oh, what a boring voice. Do you like him?
I tell you who's boring. Darren Adam. Darren Adam.
Oh, you
boring.
Don't? Now, I like him. Isn't that funny? I quite like his voice.
But yeah. He's Scottish, though, Chris.
So? Okay, Binoo! There's nothing wrong with a nice bit of vegetarian haggis. You know how they make vegetarian haggis?
Mm-hmm.
They get a plastic bag, chop up the carrot and put it in there. Vegetarian haggis. Don't. I said that one the other day. I told that joke the other day on the stage at Central Station. And all these vegetarians went, what's wrong with you lot? Oh, no. Well, we're vegetarian. We're offended by that one. Well, let me tell you something else. So am I. Oh, at which point they all started clapping. I said, so you like me now that you know I'm one of you?
So it didn't go down well then?
No, eh?
So it didn't go down well then?
Oh, no sense of humour as usual. We've got another one in here, just a minute. Now, where is it now? I cut this out. Here we go. You ready for this one, Mike? You ready for this one?
Yep, go on.
Right, so this is in today's Daily Mail. Cambridge menus are racist. A Cambridge college, it's always a blooming university or a college. They want to close down these places. They really do. A Cambridge college has promised to reconsider its dining menus after students claimed they contained cultural misrepresentations. Pembroke College was criticised. Pembroke College was criticised for microaggressions against ethnic minorities by offering dishes such as Jamaican stew and Tunisian rice.
Oh, so that sounds nice, actually.
Is that the offence?
Well,
it goes on. Students took to social media to say that they felt invalidated by the menus. An anonymous post said, if people feel their cultures are misrepresented, they have the right to address this. Microaggressions are the reality of everyday existence of many people of colour. Others responded to the row with humour. Don't get me started on Yorkshire pudding, said one response. You must be very offended by that, Mike. Yorkshire puddings.
But you see, I've...
That
I've
is a microaggression.
I've never tried a Jamaican stew, so how does it taste?
Do you know, it sounds really nice, actually, doesn't it?
It does. It does. It sounds really nice.
And you can always, you know, whatever, if you are a vegetarian like myself, you can simply take out the meat and replace it with cubes of corn. Tastes exactly the same. Because it's the spices that make the taste, Mike.
It's No. I couldn't take the meat out. No.
Oh, no. Poor little dead animal going around and round in that big old pot.
But next week I've got belly pork for lunch.
Oh, dear. Let me finish this off. College authorities said that they encourage catering staff to take the views of any of our serious students. Serious. What a load of old crap that is.
What a load
Jamaican of old... Jamaican stew. What's wrong with Jamaican stew? Does it come... Is that where the recipe came from? Jamaica? Well, what else do you want to call it?
Very true. Very
stupid true. People. Tunisian rice. Now, where does Tunisian rice come from? Now, let's think. Does it come from the Isle of Wight? No, I don't think. Does it come from Scotland? Does it come from Tunisia? Or maybe. Oh, let's call it Tunisian rice. Idiots. Idiots. As always, idiots.
They are quite.
All right, anyway, Mikey.
Anyway, how are we doing these days, Chris?
All right? I'm all right, thanks. Yeah, I'm going to finish up now and do my dinner in a moment because it's nearly 2 o'clock, isn't it? I can't believe how late it is.
I know. I was just watching. I thought, look at the time.
Yeah, I know.
Look
ever
at
so
the
late.
Time.
Never mind, Mike. Thanks ever so much for calling. Always a pleasure to hear your voice, sir.
Right, thanks, Chris.
Keep radioing. Cheerio now.
See you later.
Bye, Mike. There we are. That's lovely, Mike. He's up in Newcastle. Oh, hang on. Cancel that. Right. We'll just do our little finish off our messages from... let me just take that phone number off there. There we go. Lines are now closed. If only you'd call in earlier. No point calling in now. Lines are closed. Simon also says, on the subject of computer games, we were talking about computer games on Thursday's show, weren't we? When we were children, we had Pac-Mac. Oh, yeah. I love Pac-Man. That was my favourite computer game. And Daily Thompson's Decathlon. Now, I remember that, Daily Thompson's Decathlon, but I don't think I ever played it. It didn't have much interest to me. I played Pac-Man, Space Invaders and Asteroids, where you had to keep blowing up this rock. But as well as doing that, we went out road bikes, rope swings and played football and cricket and went swimming. Yes, as indeed most of the children of our area, of our era. That's the thing, you see. Now, it is just the computer game. They don't do anything else. I don't think it's very good for them. All right. There was an email here. Came in from James Bates. Hello, James, who says, hi, Chris. Hope you're okay. Starting to tune into a few of your shows again. You were talking about pubs closing down and being turned into flats. And also what is happening to some of the pubs that are closing down. Around where I've been, they turn these into small supermarkets as well. Yeah, I mean, how many blooming Sainsbury's Local and Tesco's Expresses can you have in a road? There's one road, actually, in Hammersmith Shepherd's Bush. Askew Road. My God, there's about 5 supermarkets down there, all on either side of the road. Why do we need so many supermarkets? Ridiculous. I hope Ron is okay. I haven't seen him in some of your shows recently. Yeah, he's all right. Hope the cat's doing well. She's very old now. Walks around in circles a lot of the time. Adam says we need to fit one of those little hamster wheels for Katie to walk around in. Then she could, her walking around wouldn't be in vain, would it? She could be generating the electricity that I use to make these programmes. Thank you very much. And one more person to say hello to today, who's new to the show, actually. This is Trevor. Hello, Trevor. And Trevor watches the show via the YouTube recording later on. Who says, he says, you don't respond to your YouTube chat, Mr. Sneezing Man. Why is that? Because I sneeze a lot. The only reason for that is I don't spot the messages sometimes. You've kind of got to be looking for the ones that appear. at the end of the YouTube shows, and I just missed them. So sometimes that happens. Sorry about that, OK? I have moved most of my stuff over to Facebook now. And Trevor said, I thought that was the case. I don't really do Facebook, but I still watch you on YouTube. I live on a narrowboat. That's fantastic. Now, I know two ladies who live on a narrowboat, and they love it. They absolutely love living on the narrowboat. And I said, isn't that expensive? You know, I heard that the moorings are very expensive. And apparently not if you keep moving it. Now, when she said that, I should have asked her, you know, what do you mean by keep moving it? Is that daily, weekly, every month? Don't know. But apparently if you're moored up for a period of time, it costs a lot of money. But if you keep moving, then that's okay. But the only thing is, you know, aren't moorings at a bit of a premium now? You know, if you went to move to find another one, what if you don't find one? What happens then? Do you just keep moving 24 hours a day? We just stop anywhere. Just stop anywhere and be done with it. You know, tap a nail into the wall there and just tie yourself up to it, okay? So thank you very much for that. And I think we're done there, boys and girls. I think we're done there this evening. Yep, we're done there this afternoon. Any more messages to read before I do the birthdays today? Oh, I think we're done. Are we done? One minute. Getting a bit confused here. There we are. Yeah, Adam was the last message, wasn't it? About the 2014 thing. Okay. All right, gang. Let's do today's birthdays. We've got a few birthdays today. Let me see. Happy birthday today to David Hunt, who is 31 years old today. Happy birthday, David. All right. Nice to see you, sir. Happy birthday to Vince Rose Lee Tidswell. Tidswell, one of the two, 34 years old today. Looking very good for 34, sir. Happy birthday. Peter Bliss, birthday today. Mike Cody, 54 today. Oh, same age as me. Chris Kennelly is 55 today. Mr. Flower Man, happy birthday, Chris. Jarrad Brook, who does a lot of work on Australian radio, is 30 today. Nice to see you, Jarrad. All right, happy birthday. John Dixon today, 47. Andrew Keats of theatre fame is 31 years old today. Happy birthday, Andrew. Jason Sutton. Miss Jason, tonight, 49. Come on, Miss Jason, you're older than me, aren't you, love? 49? Who are you trying to kid there? Well, I don't believe that. I'm sorry, I don't. But happy birthday to excellent top drag queen and lovely person, Jason Sutton, today, 49 today. And Peter May, who's often in Central Station on Saturdays and for some of the karaoke's, he'll probably be out today for his birthday, I would guess, tonight, is 76 years old today, aren't you, sir? Happy birthday to your Peter. All right, might see you tonight with Simon. Here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Okay? Happy birthday, boys and girls. Just a couple of more comments coming in towards the end of the show there. Adam says, yes, Chris, I am your historian. So any information you need to know, please just ask. Thank you very much. Jerry says, what do you think of the new phones? The Nokia 3310s. If you want one of those. If you're not bothered about going on the internet, then I'd certainly buy one. I would buy a Nokia 3310 if I didn't use it as a smartphone and sat nav and everything else I got on this phone now. So, yeah, I would totally use that. Yeah, yeah. And Wendy says, I love Mike's accent. Yeah, the Newcastle accent is nice. My favourite accent, actually, with men would be Liverpool. I love the Liverpool accent. Beautiful, beautiful. That's it today then, gang. Later on tonight, I'll be hosting karaoke at Central Station. It's Monday night karaoke tonight at Central Station, Wharfdale Road in King's Cross, London. Starts at 8 o'clock and finishes at 11:30. And it's cheap drinks as well tonight, OK? You can come and sing or you can come and watch. All right, we've got a few more chairs now. We've been running out of chairs there, so we've got a few more chairs in there as well, all right? So that's karaoke tonight and every Monday at Central Station Bar in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, starting at 8 o'clock and finishing at 11:30. Thanks very much for watching and listening. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye now.